Still that. Gaming.
That's strange early park.
Yeah, very.
Could be the relocate though, like to set up an initiation for that. But yeah.
Seems like 10 seconds remaining. Puck's way better versus the Oracle.
And Darkseer for that matter. 5 seconds
yeah, remaining. I guess you have that going on for you. With the Puck, you're gonna be able to jump behind and silence the Oracle. Reserve maybe time. Even get an early Dagon so you can actually kill her first. So seems like a solid idea from Wings.
If you were Wings, would you have considered banning the P8, considering that MVP I don't think they've lost with
it? I would ban Darkseer though. I think Darkseer made the PA very strong.
Okay, you don't think it's the PA independently?
Yeah. Like because of the Iron Shell, that's number one. And number two is like not every offlaner can fight all the time. You don't want to have an offlaner that relies on cooldown, and you want an offlaner that can buy mech as well. So not many offlaner fulfills that criteria.
It becomes hard to gauge if Wings are that kind of team. I mean, they welcomed the Darkseer PA with open arms and prepped that they had something ready for it. After all, you really never know. Radiant right? Okay, that this, hero's back somehow.
This looks like a very, very comfortable opening for MVP. Like, as always, all their melee heroes with the Iron Shell. I mean, Shiva brought a pretty legit point about the techies against all the melee heroes.
Yeah, of course. Are you saying it's time for techies 10 again? 10 seconds
remaining. I mean, if you have 5 melee heroes, why not?
I think if you lost like five you did against remaining. DC though, I think you're like about that. Especially when you have a draw lineup, right, with Puck.
He has like reserve permanent time. Double damage.
I mean, because it's Wings, you know, so I don't know what's gonna happen.
Dude, 40 times 2 is not that high, Ben. Puck draw though, I think right now it's the battle of Wings have the counter initiation with the Gust and the Puck going in, but if MVP plays this right, especially in the laning phase, probably gonna do the dual lane, right? The Darkseer and
a fistful of tangos on the same team.
So offlane Puck off-lane, now?
Offlane Quap?
No, I think Puck is more because you need
probably Puck.
You need
we've seen them it, both happen.
Isn't Quap way better?
Yeah, but you need more farm on the Quap. You need Quap to snowball where Puck can probably afford a much weaker start.
Because so. You really that's the issue with him, is you get the blink and then it becomes underwhelming in this meta.
What about support Quap? We've seen it a few times, even in competitive.
I've seen High Cat way back in the day, remember that.
I don't know, because his Wings is like, I don't know what they're gonna do, you know? We'll just see if it's the final pick. Generally, you would expect offlane Puck.
Maybe another mid laner, because why not?
Why do we say generally expect offlane, considering that hero never gets picked, it's just Wings. Yeah, what they do.
If one of these two teams like walk away with the TI title, it's like, let's just throw strategy out the window at this point. Moving into the final bans, MVP make sure they get rid of some possible early game aggression from the drum. 10 seconds by getting rid of the Chen. And we go to Wings Gaming for the final ban here. 5 seconds
remaining. Wait, is there still ET left?
Yeah. That hero is still available. Reserve time. Wings won it.
Alright, what about Earthshaker, Ben?
Earthshaker is really good versus the melee hero. Yeah, that's a good idea.
I think for Wings, the common theme right now is you need to be able to disengage and simply get away and create some distance between your ranged heroes and MVP. Because MVPs, you know what they're going to do. They're just going to run at you for 25 minutes.
And then it might actually allow them to do like Earthshaker Quap off lane and pressure. That lane is decent.
Winter.
Yeah, that lane is decent. Then you can have like Puck mid, which is hard to gank.
This is one of the few lineups where I would actually advocate something like the ES. One of the Radiant ones. Team
pick. Ban comes out on the Faceless Void, and we'll have to see.
Nope!
It's a Warlock! Team pick.
Upheaval against melee heroes? I mean, okay. MVP finish up with the Class Vex Invoker that they always go for. Very, very typical MVP stuff. They're gonna run at you, they're gonna keep fighting. Don't need much farm.
Is Warlock the answer?
They brought out a Warlock against MVP. How dare you?
I don't know, man. I'm just gonna go for MVP Dakota.
Alright, fair enough. It's a hard one to gauge, but if you guys had anything else to say on it, nope.
MVP.
Let's just see.
All the way.
Let's see the action break out for itself. Let's go ahead and send it to the floor now where we have LD and Mott.
Thanks so much, guys. And we are here trying to determine who is going to be top three at TI6 for three or at least $2 million, LD. And what a draft to start us off with this game one.
I am expecting nothing but blood, Mutt. It's all ranged heroes. Yes, Wings want to kite, but this is a team that plays aggressive in their own right. MVP, nothing different here. Just typical face rush Dota from them. They also have the Dubu Earth Spirit. This guy is an absolute master on the hero. Combine that with Ion Shell. Lots of early pressure for MVP. Wings early warding, support positioning will be extremely important. And they need levels on these supports. It's a Warlock and an Io, so they have to have a decent laning state.
If they can get that Chaotic Offering, they could stop that MVP aggression with that Golem and see how much damage they can pump out.
But look at this, MVP already invading the jungle.
They're gonna jump in, there's gonna be this... He's the dagger, Shadow gets caught, there's gonna be the Rolling Boulder. Cold Snap
first
as well,
blood.
And Shadow will be your first blood. And already,
they want more.
Beacon on the board. Blink will be able to blink away. Mech Co-op, but still, first blood going the way of MVP, as you would expect. With this Faith Rush style.
You know, generally, that's a pretty good position in the jungle to break smokes, and he was fairly far back, but PA's dagger just has absolutely insane range. Even at level one, it's got ridiculously long catch potential. Just got caught off guard. That's where a position where you'd ideally like the Queen of Pain to be, maybe the Puck, if you're gonna put the Drow there, have more support behind her, but this is just, it just seems to happen when MVP's playing. Teams just don't respect how aggressive they are. Once again, off to a hot start here. They do get the Bounty Rune for the Invoker. So as for the Lades mod, it looks like it will be the Queen of Pain mid. So they're going to run the offlane Puck for Faith Beyond. He might get help from the Io, though, which is a pretty scary dual lane with the Drow.
This is the draft panel was talking about it. This is one of the most interesting drafts you'll see. And it's Wings that does it. They just pick so many crazy heroes. They were thinking Techie's there for a little bit. And that's not going to be picked up, though. Wings will have that Io helping out Faith Beyond in the offlane to begin with. There's QO sitting in the safe lane trying to farm up and FIP as well, trying to zone out. The three lanes are situated now. MP versus Blink. Pretty solid matchup. And how do you feel about this Invoker going up against the Co-op in this one?
It's a cross Wix Invoker up against Drow Ranger Aura on Queen of Pain. So generally you would say Invoker is going to have a tough time here. He does have a lot of regen with Quas. He's not going to die, but last hitting is generally difficult. But the good news for him is he's already getting help. He goes in with the Tornado now. And going to force out the Blink from Blink himself. The Earth Spirit started there to help secure the lane. So he's not being left entirely on the island, but look at this.
They want to go in the eye with the Rolling Boulder in as well. This is trouble for Wings, and it looks like they might lose it. It's no tether. Able to at least try to get alive, but it's too much damage coming out, and Wings will lose yet another hero with that aggression. And Dubu rotates up top early to get that kill.
They have no ward vision right now of the runes or the Earth Spirit's potential rotations. Only one hill ward. It does spot the Iron Talon jungling for F Darkseer. So bottom lane, entirely abandoned. Drow free farm. This is generally where a lot of teams would look to roam a support, maybe try to secure the mid lane, potentially go assist that top lane. You're running a Warlock support. This hero needs levels. Speaking of which,
well, that mid, aggressive Blink coming out from the mid player, and MP will co-toad it. So he has the Quas helping him regen, but the Shadow Strike there. He has the Fire Feed, and Invoker, but it looks like there will be no extra kills going the way of either side.
He secures a Haster in top with the Earth Spirit. Looks like more support rotations. Ice is going to come in mid, but he has been scouted, Mod. He walked by dire wards for this.
Middle tower, and it is going to be a Warlock support rotation. It's not the best thing. No upheaval skilled up either, so it's the Fatal Bond, the Shadow Word as well to help out, but that's not going to be able to do too much, and he will head back down towards that bottom rune spot. Dubu's still on the hill getting set up. He'll be looking for a Rolling Boulder, but they want to bait off this aggressive Blink. Instead, he will blink defensively. He doesn't get up the high ground, but he's going to get away just fine. Dubu, he's putting a little pressure on at this point.
Yeah, I am. I'm glad you brought it up, because I think it's worth discussion, and I'm curious to see if Ice will go for many points in upheaval this game. It sounds amazing against three melee heroes and just a Faith Rush lineup as they again move in on Blink, forcing him to back out once more, but is it really that good? PA has Blink Strike to get out of it. You've Surge on the Darkseer, and Earth Spirit has the Rolling Boulder. So all three heroes can pretty easily just remove themselves from upheaval. I feel like with Wings, this was more a pick design just to fuel the five-man push, but they'll need the Golem before he can really come into play. There's again a movement. Dubu trying to set up Faith. You already used the Orb, unfortunately. Kick.
Gonna get that stunned up. That's a great Boulder smash. A lot of plenty of damage.
They have no idea what Earth Spirit is doing. That ward is not helpful in this situation, and Punk is the Orb to offensively harass and farm. You can't do that when the Io's not behind you and when you have no vision. It's just a lack of vision.
Dire's bottom
really
tower is under attack. Yeah. Wings, they seem a little bit spin at this point in time. This world can't help them out. The Io's too low level at this point. Maybe he could have overcharged, but even then, when you, like you said, offensively use that Illusory Orb, you are more than likely going to go down, and he does. So Faith Beyond, not the best off lane, not the best start. Definitely dagger dodged nicely by the ship. He has the Waiting Rift as well, but
he has CS. Well, that's the beauty of having Drow Ranger. as he might be able to get a kill here on 4F. 4F does back away. Faithion's going in for this.
Not going Boulder away. Meanwhile, looks like they're going to be okay for the time being. 4F is able to surge himself out and looks like they will get out. Faithion was looking for that kill, but he's not successful in doing so.
Yeah, he saw Darkseer go to farm the big camp. He knew he was low. He didn't know exactly where he was, but he's still chasing Mod. 4F's greed might be punished. This could be huge.
He's trying to TP out the Illusion on his there in time. Oh, he actually hit it, but it didn't do enough damage. He's sitting at base with maybe 10 HP. Jump in mid, Scream of Pain, MP with the Shadow Strike as well, but he's regenerating.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
He should sit behind
they're wrapping around. MP is a big kill. He can poke Ghostwalk, though. The orb's going to connect. They get him. Wings, they need a back kill. Fortified,
just like me. That's a big pick going their way.
Dire's middle tower is all alone in the world. Beam
there
attacked.
As well. Dubu it in. Level 2 to that boulder smash as well as the rolling boulder, but needs more help here if wants to try to find something. It's like they will back away with a little bit of power pressure
for the radiant.
So looking at the drafts, Wings left to push, right? They pick the Drow, they have the Warlock. This lineup has pickoff potential, but they're primarily about attack. Five man. They really have to be careful about QO coming to fights. PH is actually very scary, even in early engagements with basic farm. He's about to hit level 6. They definitely need to keep tabs on him. Their natural goal is going to be once the Golem is up to push with that, but they better mind the PA's position.
Dire's
they
bottom
can
tower is under attack. Run for the bottom tower.
Was waiting for to be involved or just levels or...
Mainly just levels. Getting the max dagger is really important. Having 1 point in crit, but bottom lane action breaks up.
Boulder smash on to 2. Beautifully from Dubu. They get the silence as well on both turns. And now Shadow in trouble. The Shadow Ward healing him up. They get the overturn. The Tether. Great turnaround. Can they get the kill? The surge away. Dubu will survive. The Frost Air Force not helping with that surge. And the Dark Surge so close with both teams going down there.
And speaking of rotation, Mod. Hey guys, QO has decided it's time to take a fight bottom. They're all low. There was a ward scouting this. Four heroes coming bottom potentially. MP thinking about it depending on the route. He's gonna get a regen. They're diving for this spot. Look at this aggression from MVP.
QO really wants to kill here. Itself. Not sure he's going to find it. Innocence might be the best target though. He's got no tether and he dies with the three hits. The stifling down helping him four out. Body blocking as well, but again, more shadow words from my side. Still low. Grapple trying to TP away. Gus will not stop it, but he will make it out, doing some nice damage though. Shadow almost bringing four of down.
Wings, no TPs on either core there. Faithbeyond on the puff did not have one. He's not quite level 6. And equally importantly, Blake has not skilled the ultimate yet because he went for the 2 points in Shadow Strike and wants the max Scream Pain. He doesn't have a TP either. You have to carry TPs on your cores when you're up against MVP. They will dive you, they will punish you, and they're gonna keep tabs on those inventories as well.
Again, it's all about those levels for those Wings supports right now, and you're looking at it here. Level 5 for this Warlock, so he's getting closer and closer to that Chaotic Offering, that Golem. I could turn fights quickly, and he has
by
to go to the Shadow Ward
the
as well.
Bottom tower doesn't even have arms to defend itself.
They have some long cooldowns here, though.
Dire's bottom tower has
roll
fallen.
Bottom, they
it
catch up Shadow.
Another great boulder match. Dubu finding him. Perez going to come up with the Iron Shell, and that is a kill between the Darkseer as well as an Earthspirit. And it's just that easy. Too far up there through the Drow Ranger.
Yeah, they have a lane ward behind the tower. They could potentially dive Ice. They know he doesn't have backup for now. The double Iron Shell is scary. They don't know exactly how close he is to level 6, though. And there are TPs on the two teamfight specialists for Wings. Faithbeyon has one on the puck. Blink has one on Quap, but is a bit low on mana. The Courier coming out to rejuvenate him. But Dubu, who has been hugely impactful, already 4 assists, involved about 80% of their kills, looks to make another one happen in the mid lane.
He's going
to
drop ward first, get some vision on. Eyes on Blink in the mid lane now, and whoever rotates into that tier 1 tower more than likely.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Warlock is gonna
I feel
nice
sad.
Smoke now, but he walked past the ward, they're gonna try to cut him off.
Ice, yeah. They've targeted him. He said, okay, we'll see you. I'm just gonna keep tabs on that Warlock for now.
You can just see from the way they're moving, like, even if they don't go for the kill, they're always thinking about where is that next kill gonna come from.
Oh my. The crit on the Stifling Dagger never feels good, and Faithbeyond has to feel the repercussions from it, so he'll salve up. We'll be back to full health here again
is
the dive
attack.
Bottom.
It has Brett no arms to defend itself.
Shadow under the tree line, and he's missing out on farm because of this.
They smoked at the same time on Ice Ice on the Warlock.
MVP aren't going to show up to defend that tower. They just have to find a hero in the jungle potentially.
Just the boulder smash bottom. It's not actually a dive from MVP.
Radiant's top
tower. Not
going to
take the bait bottom. Kill here could lead to a tower.
Green Squall jump and scream. Radiant's top tower is falling.
Not so radiant anymore.
Needs to use the protection.
Radiant's bottom tower has seen better days.
Head invoker with the ghost walk on.
And they still have the Warlock bolt. They should be a tier 2. But BB spreading the map. They leave QO top. 4F bottom. I'm still waiting on the mech here for 4F. 4 to level 6 is very close. Invoker starting to come online, but only has the 3 points to Wex. He's not really in full fighting shape just yet, but once they get that near Spiritle, they are going to want to take team fights. They just want to fight around the big ultimate cooldowns on Wing. MVP can fight pretty much constantly. It's Wing to rely more so on their ultimates.
The more I see this pick, the Phantom Assassin, the more I love it against the ground. Jumping in, you have floor, obviously. Bottom tower might get denied. Nicely done, but he might pay for it. He's Blink up, ready to go, but Sonic will go first. Yubi will take the majority of that damage. Still, Pop Blinks away, gets out in time, and gets the deny on that tower.
Yeah, with the tower deny, probably still worth it, but Colt is a long cooldown.
Yes.
This may deter grouping up, and you really want that magic damage against PA. Can't rely on right clicks against evasion. One of the other reasons where the PA pick feels really solid is you're up against a drow line, a 5 Rick hero, so nobody else is really a traditional right clicker. Quap can scale a bit that way, but evasion just against Drow alone is so useful to have.
For the Vlad, the choice for the Phantom Assassin, just some extra stats, armor, damage going your way.
It's might be able to Roche now with the hold down. It's a little bit risky, but MVP, known for taking some risks. They did paint out the pit.
If there's a team that is a risk-taking team, MVP, I don't know what you want to call it, but they're actually kind of just ridiculous with their movements. And Base Beyond, though, on the offlane puck, is actually doing so well. He's very close to... Actually, he bought the drum. I thought he was just saving for the blink tagger, but he picked up the drum instead. Give his team some stats. 4F, though, on the other side. Looks like he will be mech on that Darkseer. All right. Setting up down bottom. A couple of heroes rotating in. Wings, again, still have that Chaotic Offering yet to use it. The Warlock's nearby. They have the invised up Queen of Pain.
They saw Blink. The smoke will break.
Hugo's gonna back. He's gonna throw one Stifling Dagger, face shifted nicely by the buff. You lose your arm coming through, no jaunt forward. Lots of good vision coming out from the MVP side, though. If you look across this jungle, they have a lot of good wards. One down in that bottom lane, one in the jungle, and then one towards that mid lane that Dubu put down. So some really nice vision coming out from MVP LD.
You really want vision against this strong five man so that you don't have to fight them all at once. This is where you look for quick pickoffs, hit and run tactics from MVP. Vision is what fuels it.
Again, from MP, he'll walk past that ward. It feels like that ward's been there for forever, and it's actually just going to go down now, but they will see MP rotate in. Oh. They smoke up, though.
The Radiant Ward they just had bottom has expired, Mod. Otherwise, they would see this coming, but they might sense it anyway.
The Radiant should really do something about that middle tower.
In the Roche Pit right now. It looks like it is going to be that. So they scan, and they will be successful. Radiant.
MP walks by. He throws out a Tornado. Very confident positioning from him. I wonder if Wings are going to react to this.
Top tower is doing
so
best,
scary around the pit. This is a really big risk by MVP.
This will take a while, too. No armor reduction. Illusion Orb in. They'll see Febby. And now it's time for MVP to escape the pit. There's the surge out. Jump in for QO, though. He wants to go on Blink with the Shadow Ward. And another Cycling Dagger crit coming out from QO.
They have relocate. Remember, Wings effectively have five heroes here. Space Beyond Jaunt's in. That's pretty deep.
I can really push it, not yet anyways. Dubu going to that Night Sight. There's some magic time to stop on Blink as well. Tornado will clip Night Sight. They have the Chaotic Offering. Will they get it off in time? Yes. Doesn't hit anybody though. No real disables coming out of Night Sight solo. The Magnetize not bringing him down, but Dubu plays out of play to my Shadow with QO. Goes to the work. Sonic Wave coming in. Clips onto two. Neck back up. MVP running over and over. Blink must be next.
Double kill.
Oh, dead. It's a double kill.
They're
coming
just completely out finessing Wings in the fight, never getting hit by the Chaotic Offering. Juking by all the big ultimates, catching them out one by one. Even though Wings had five, it didn't feel like it, Mod. Big Beyond 2 might go down.
Tornado from MP. There's a fairy fire from Big Beyond. Trying to man up, and the goal of getting the double kill. Wings, they will at least get a couple in retaliation, LD.
They did use all three ultimates for that. They lost everyone else. That is a clear win for MVP, but it does salvage the fight. So you see here, a great silence on Blink, keeps him out. Ice Ice forced to use the Golem, as you mentioned, doesn't really hit anything. I think might have clipped MP there, but it's not good enough. You need multiple hero bonds with the ultimate. Shadow now suddenly finds himself in front of the fight. This is just how mobile the MVP draft is. They bring him down. The Ice, so damn squishy. She drops. Really nice usage of the Oracle ult there to help ensure QO can stay alive and be even more aggressive. Almost ties to the Golem, but almost doesn't count, and that's just kind of what this Wings, this MVP draft counts on, is barely winning fights and then turning those slight advantages into a huge lead. So very well fought by them, and Real, it's tricky. They're all squishy. Your positioning has to be perfect on Wings.
Yeah, they will have the mech to help out though on Wings' side. They're building it up on Ice as we speak. He has the headdress now. Just about done. MVP will head back into Roshan Pit. This time they have a Blight to help out. They want potentially a Desolator for QO, the Blight Deso combo. Somewhat, I would almost call a standard build, but for Phantom Assassins, we haven't seen them enough to really see what's standard at this point.
Yeah, some players will work in an Echo Saver. BKB is quite core in most games. This game, there's the Golem Sun and there's the Queen of Pain Hold, but I still think it's a pretty good BKB game. Lets you man up on the draw a lot, so probably won't go for it first, but at some point may incorporate it into his build.
Dire's top still though, tower is under attack.
We know what MVP already likes to do. They like to run at you. Now they have an Aegis. The next step for them is reestablishing that map control over the enemy jungle. Wing's actually leading when it comes to golden experience, but MVP will not just sit back and trade farm. You're not seeing a bad Fury PA. Invoker, not even going for an early farming build. He does normally go back for the Midas, but MP having a bit of a rougher game just now completing the drum, so it's just typical MVP, the way they're itemizing. They want to fight. They do not want to sit back and trade farm.
Only 46 CS for the Invoker, and net worth-wise, he's below the offlane puck. Link Dagger is done for the Darkseer, however, and that's going to be great for setups. What level is this Darkseer? Level 10, so he has 3 points in the vacuum, 1 point in the wall. He's about to be 11, so those 2 points in his ultimate are going to come out soon. But Link is just cutting the creep wave, and they're going to try to split this up as best as possible. EMP, cold snap, it hits nicely, but it's still plenty of mana for Blink to...
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. I feel sad for
that. That's a really nice maneuver by him. It's going to slow down MVP's ability to push and take towers, and that's really what they want to do, is force objectives while Wings have to fight in the Aegis. As for Wings, they'll be looking to trade, they'll be looking to stall. And they are going for the split push top lane. It's kind of tough for MVP to come defend a tower. They definitely can't see people
attack.
And they also, Wings Brawl, will push a lot faster. Quads Rex Invoker, Quads Exhort. No deaths on PA yet, so I'm quite liking the way Wayne is adapting to this. Just, hey, MVP are fighting really well. They have Aegis. They're building a fight. Let's just push towers instead and avoid those fights inside.
It's not like MVP can keep there, like you said. They would be fighting into that Warlock Golem, which is back up. They're still trying to push that Tier 2 tower bottom lane. So maybe successfully. Wing's not rotating over yet. They're just getting farmed themselves. Wing Dagger is now done for Faith Beyond.
Radiant structures are fortified. That means you can't
They're
hurt
also
right
waiting
now
on the mech for Ice Ice. He's very close to it. The Darkseer pick was instrumental in that last attack team fight, but now Wing, they can equalize the score here.
And I don't mean
not only
that,
the Queen Hate building into the Orc and Levelance as well. So everyone getting their items for Wing right now.
Orchid is potentially game-changing. Pretty much every single MVP hero it's good against. Excels versus the Oracle and the Invoker. Those are ideally the two heroes you want to focus, but just blowing up the Oracle at the start of the fight, that means QO is going to be much less confident, especially once the Aegis expires. So I think so far, Wings really doing a good job at not falling prey to the MVP snowball effect mod. But as I say that, MVP on the smoke again.
QO's Desolator now finished up, and he finds himself in double damage rune. This could be ugly. Wings not careful. Their positioning right now, solid. Behind their tier 2 tower, not showing themselves in that ward towards the jungle. And MP and MVP might not
He wants
find
to go in.
Yeah, they want to go for the high ground. The smoke is broken. There's the Drip Coil. The Gust on it too as well. Lots of damage coming out. There's the Golem on top. MP might fall first. QO, he's got the Aegis. He needs to worry about that second life. Now the Sonic Wave coming through as well. And they'll take down 3. Blink gets the double. QO, hearing, looking for Ice Ice, gets the crit, but it's not enough damage to QO. He's getting kited. He can't do the Sonic though. Hit Faith Beyond comes in and finds another kill.
What a terrible choke point for MVP to fight into. They're walking up a cliff without vision into a Warlock, the Queen of Pain. The Warlock only hit one hero. The PA actually managed to dodge away to the north. 3 heroes escaped to the south. But the thing was, it spread out the fight regardless. So suddenly your PA with an Aegis is completely isolated, kept away from the Oracle. The Silence also basically deleted those 3 heroes that were to the south of the trees. And from there, fantastic Queen of Pain play by Blake. We'll get another look at it here.
Did in the replay, they just get caught with that Druid Coil onto 2. Could have been even better if Ice Ice was a bit quicker on the draw with that ultimate, but they get plenty of kills. Go have Wings. They get the Aegis. Brings out a lot of heroes for MVP side. So now that net worth lead increased to 5,000 for Wings.
MVP really, the way they win fights is by getting a kill to start them. If they walk into a 5v5, they don't instantly blow someone up. At this stage, they're gonna get kited and controlled. PA cannot do it alone. This is a game where PA needs that Oracle ultimate to help her out. Surge, they invoke her, isolating heroes, Earth Spirit silencing them, but it shows you the zoning potential Wings lineup has. And coming into the series, a lot of people talk about, oh yeah, MVP loves to run five melee heroes. There's not five this game, but it is a face rush draft. It's an in-your-face lineup, and pretty much everything Wings has both picked is either good at disengaging or good at punishing aggression.
Yeah.
If you group up,
Grenada will catch base beyond that. Lose your arms aggressively. He does get stunned up as well. Look at that damage. They bring him down with a purifying flame. 4-10. And MP's old snap. That's plenty of damage. He's on the sideline now. And with no chaotic offering, it looks like MVP might be able to push the tier 1 tower mid lane.
Duo is already on the hunt again. They do have a ward here. They saw Blink go to the creep camp.
We're blinking.
They see him now.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
He gets the hell out of there.
Maybe a lucky crit would help him out in getting that kill, but...
Fort Kiting Gold, not a hurricane.
No more.
Yeah, they're just trying to keep themselves away from MVP, and they want to dictate the fights here. Wings want to be the one to keep the pressure up, split push the lanes, make sure everything is going their way. But Dooku will put up a nice aggressive ward here. He'll keep you out as well, but it slows down. And again, with MVP having that face rush lineup, with it slowing down,
middle tower is under attack.
Almost certainly favorite.
That's not
going to
hold.
They've got going on right now.
Now, MVP are controlling the map. They're out farming Wings for now. And for Wings, they really struggle to fight when they're either not. Oh, hold on. They caught Blink again.
They got the arc, and Dooku should fall to the shadow trick. It looks like he will go down. The gust is up, and now Duo. He just blow up.
And now Shadow might be in trouble here. He's been left alone. They try to burst him. Oh, baby. Barely escapes. They relocate him in, but the IO dies instantly, so he did not have an easy getaway plan. Good news for him is MVP with the Earth Spirit death, light on any sort of control. So, could have been really bad bringing the Drow in and losing her there too, but works out okay.
So, 20 minutes into this game, looking towards that next Roshan potentially. Not up for a little bit of time here as MVP. They want to be able to get into that pit, especially with that Desolator. The PA, and you were talking about this, the BKB choice. It looks like that might be next for QO on the Phantom Assassin. So, good chance that he's going to have some match community pretty soon.
Yeah, as mentioned, there are some things that pierce this, but it allows him to be much more confident in the fights. He doesn't have to worry about getting Orchided, getting Gusted back, and he can more confidently commit in. He also doesn't rely on his team as much to stay alive. So, even if the fight gets spread out, QO can still be doing work, and then the team rejoins. It's, I think given the way MVP have itemized, this is an essential item, even if it doesn't block everything. But at the same time, we still have tools to kite even through that. Like, you still can Hurricane Pike yourself away, the Puck can phase shift, it's now level 3, getting to that point where you can always reliably phase shift Blink out. Warlock, once he drops his ult, doesn't care too much if he dies. Wings, though, on the move.
Smoke up, Patreon looking to jump in. He's going to find the waiting room for Lucio. There's the stream. MP will fall. And relocating Shadow as well. Dulu now. He's going to try to roll out. He will. Back you wall. Nicely done, but there's no follow-up coming out. Forever caught by that dream crawl. Stream of Pain, Shadow Strike, two down, and they might catch a third, although
the IO dies, the Drow Ranger illusion. QO looking to come in, but where's his opening?
Sebi about to go down, and actually surviving now with the Fates either coming through and that push coming in.
Sebi
has to use that Oracle ultimate just to stay alive. That Chaotic Offering boots good work, but not enough to bring down the Oracle. 2-for-1 trade, though, LD.
Wings absolutely
Dire's top tower
handling this MVP
attack.
Aggression well, and I don't really feel like MVP have much of a plan B. No Midas on Invoker. Sometimes you'll see, like we've seen MP in the past, when they don't have a mech carrier, he'll buy mech, but then he'll go back for Midas and transition into the mid game, the late game. We're not seeing that. He's going Yule Scepter now. We're not seeing a PA Battle Fury. Darkseer will farm well, but the support duo, Earth Spirit, Oracle, these heroes don't really farm. They don't have Bounty Hunters, so there's no Trackhold. This is not a lineup that farms that well. PA, in theory, scales well in the late game, but eventually Drow Ranger, she may get a Silver Edge, she may get an MKB, she gets Evasion. I don't really think MVP can count on taking this late with the way they've itemized in the hero matchup. It's very important for them to snowball, find kills, and out-map control Wings, at least bottle them up in the base. So far, though, not able to do it. Wings have just been ready for the aggression and able to react.
Yeah, a lot of the time, you see the relocate in like you talked about. Just too much damage coming in as Wings have, of course, that Drow precision aura as well. So many ranged heroes here. QO, like you said, they'll be able to deal with the slur eventually later on down the road. His BKB is almost completed, but Quap has her own as well. Blink will be able to pick the Haste Rune along with it. So Wings are starting to control the map a bit better. They could use some extra map control. There are still very good wards placed down by the over towards that Roche pit. For Wings, they have the pretty much entire Dire jungle controlled here. Some good wards at the entry as well as on that Uber cliff.
And now, Mott, they look for a smoke. They can also Roche very quickly with the Drow, but it's not up yet. They're hunting for kills. Maybe gonna try to drop a ward. There's a haste rune bottled on Blink. He also has his BKB now. You can still Blink Strike on BKB targets, but Faith Beyond, he finds the jump. I think that's too deep for Wings.
Yeah, that's underneath the tier 3 tower. They don't want to commit too hard. They lose a fight there, and they might lose all this advantage that they've garnered over the course of this game. 24 minutes in, and that does mean that Kuo will get his BKB, and that might be an important item. They're going to counter smoke for MVP, and they're going to look for a target. They're going to draw a line and head straight down towards that Roche pit. They want that pickoff before they head into the pit, LD.
They would love to just take Roche now, knowing that Coil's on cooldown, but unfortunately for MVP, it's going to be just about a minute, exactly the amount of time the puck needs, not 40 seconds, till the Coil's ready. They need a kill, like you said.
This smoke might be broken by Faith Beyond if they walk up in the wrong direction.
Great positioning to break a smoke by them, and a very elusive hero as well.
They're going to go elsewhere. They're looking for Shadow, and they might find him. They jump in. He's going to get caught, but there's the BKB. Wall dropped down, but no vacuum. There's a hero kid in from Innocent. Dubu gets crushed by the right click. Can't offering elsewhere. Ice Ice is low. We'll go down to the Purifying Flame. So far, one for one exchange. QO now. BKB's up. The Sonic Wave goes right through it, but he will have this get the IO. Now trying to man up against Shadow. It's not enough, LD. He goes down. The most important hero for MVP has fallen.
He didn't. He's too squishy. Didn't have the help of the Oracle in that fight. Now they're looking for more. The Invoker on the run. Wings, though, no detection.
Steffi is going to have to use again that Oracle ulti.
But they're flanking with Shadow.
Come in, there's the Druid World Blink. Oh, mana before does he blow up after that Oracle ulti. It is done. It's going to be a 3 going down for MVP, I believe.
They really want to take Roche now because they used all their big ultimates there. And MVP going to respawn in about 20 seconds. You have the Ice Armor to assist with this endeavor. Age is so important for MVP, the type of lineup, like, kind of like a Huskar draft, where often it's really scary early to mid-game, can fall off late, but if Wings could take this Aegis away from MVP, it's
getting low. Rev's gonna come in, vacuum Shadow to the high ground, but he just forces himself down to the low ground with the Hurricane Pike. Dubu jumps in. The boulder smash onto two. Roche now. They will take it. Too late from MP to get that tornado EMP combo off, and Wings have the Aegis now in tow for the Drow Ranger.
That was a really well fought engagement by Wings. The only thing that didn't go well was Ice Ice dropped the rock, immediately died. We have yet to see a particularly effective Warlock ult, I would say, aside from that one fight near the tier 2 mid for Wings, but it just doesn't matter. They're doing such a good job at kiting MVP, like the distance they had to chase that Drow with the Hurricane Pike, then Io relocates in behind her to keep her alive even longer. Innocence also has a Glimmer Cape, so he can use that to save the Drow. Like, they know after that initial barrage, once the BKB wears off, if MVP haven't found a pick or two, they're gonna lose the fight. And the other thing is, man, Queen of Pain ult, that is causing problems for QO. His HP isn't that high. Dropped very quickly there to the Quap combo. BKB'd, but Evasion is not enough to save him.
Sonic Wave. Blink was ready to go. He knows that he has to be on QO. He's got to be the damage dealer. He's got to get that Sonic Wave in, make sure he does the damage to the QO PA. So for now, it looks like MVP's starting to get him back in their base. Match control going the way of Wings. And with that Aegis, it looks like 5 minutes where MVP maybe don't want to fight against this squad. And people try to get more farmed up, but there's the Mantis Style for Shadow. He is now top in the net worth. He has been for a little bit of time and still very close to the top 4 net worth at this point.
Just another way to waste QO's time in fights. You blink in, you try to blow up the Drow, suddenly she mantas, removes the slow, you might not know which the real target is. Also, obviously, great for just safely sieging the enemy base as they don't have a Shadow Demon. And again, more ways to counter the initiation. Now a Lincoln Sphere on the puck. Wings are getting so strong defensively, and you know, Drow is not the most defensible hero naturally, but with this supporting cast she has, and it's going to be tough to kill her. And then the other two cores, they are very elusive. Puck and Quap, BKB on one, Lincoln's on the other. MVP just haven't found that snowball. The quick bursts haven't been there for the most part. A couple of kills, but you need a lot more than a couple in this matchup, and especially with the way they've chosen to approach the game.
Invoker being behind for the majority of the game. Not great for Epcot. Room Coil is going to use the Guardian Creep immediately. Vacuum Ball in. Nice damage. Dubu misses the boulder smash. Sonic Wave will ground for it. Looks like he will fall for it. Kyo jumps in. BKB from Blink, and looks like he'll back away. Dominating Spree.
Not sure how much MVP want to go forward here, but they will. QO jumps in, goes to the BKB. Innocent's barely alive. The Chaotic Offering keeping him up, but now QO jumps in with another Phantom Strike. We'll find the kill. Blink away from Blink of the Cloth. Debbie.
But he's running. I thought QO only knew one direction, and that was forward. QO, wrong way, buddy.
Almost going down the Oracle ulti, keeping him alive. That all promise, but Debbie will give his life for it. QO backing up into the base. They're going forward. Faceon's in. He wants to move. It's the waiting room stuff. And one more right click. Gets the kill. The tornado is up. We might get caught. Faceon will just walk out now. Underneath the guys in the tier 3 tower. Great fight for Wings again. They take the tier 2. And they're knocking on the door of the tier 3 LG.
Oh, building fall quickly against the trap boss. Really nice play by Shadow there. Force stacking the IO back. Sure, the IO dies, but it just wastes more time for the PA's precious BKB seconds. Wings are winning the longer the fights go on, because MVP can't find quick kills.
Another vacuum, but no wall. He's already used it. Guts will be off the target there. Warp's able to dodge and sidestep it nicely. They take familiar racks. They don't want to go any further. Now that Chaotic Offering Golem is down, but that is a great start for Wings pushing the base. They will TP home. They will start pushing out the other waves and go from there.
Also want to point out, Wings dropped some really good deep wards here. This is going to make it even harder for MVP to leave the base. I'm not sure at this point if they feel like they could even win in the mid game, but if you want to transition late game, then you're looking at like trying to build back into a Midas on Invoker. It's already 30 minutes in. That sounds like a terrible idea. So I think MVP are scratching their heads. Like, what do we do?
This lineup, it was supposed to win early. They were supposed to be able, like you said, face rush this opponent Wings draft, but Wings drafted nicely.
And Wings have great access in the late game. 5 range tiers with the Drow, that's great. Blink also with the plate mail. He can build either a Shiva's or an AC. AC great for sieging. Gives that extra physical DPS. They can build into a Hex for Faith Beyond. There's the Oracle to deal with the Hex initiation, but then you're being forced to use the False Promise very early in the fight. It's not the ideal way to do it. It just further gives Wings more options, and not to mention, Warlock is scary, but if he gets off a good double Golem, the point booster now picked up, Ag's likely next, that could just instantly win them the fight. We still haven't seen a good Warlock ult, really.
Yeah, Ice.
There's the AC.
He gets a good Chaotic Offering, that's going to change the complexion of a fight and make it even worse for MVP in most cases, but we'll wait and see how that goes. It's again, more backing up and farming for Wings. This does give some time for the rest of MVP to get some items like that. Shiva's guard coming out, but here is the puck. Faith Beyond has picked up the Dagon. This offlane puck is doing so much work in this game, LD.
I mean, what do you do if you're QO now? Like, we've seen a couple fights where he wants to hang on to the BKB. He doesn't want to blow it too early, and then Wings just run away. So he tries to wait until they're committed, but if he waits, he gets hit by the Quap Bolt, he gets Dagon, he's out of the fight. At that point, he's not engaging anymore. Puts him in even more of a bind. So much pressure on the BKB timing here.
Forget the MKB for the Drow, or even the Silver Edge, it's the Butterfly that he wants. He knows that right click is going to be able to bring him down.
This is the better pushing item when the illusions get benefit from the
Alacrity smoke will break. You are walking up, they're looking for Faith Beyond, phase shift, but now Shadow Gust up. Full snap coming out.
Look at how long QO's holding his BKB.
He's gonna finally jump in looking for Shadow, but there's the Hurricane Spike. Now the Chaotic Offering up for a Sonic Wave. See you later. MP will be able to force his way out. QO pops the BKB, but they can bring him down. Ice. Max up stays alive. There's the Fortune's End. But QO now getting laid into the right click. Yeah, Phantom Strike with one more, and that'll do the job. More dead for MVP again. Demi, the only survivor he wants innocence. And it's a small consolation prize if he can get it with the Glimmer Cape saves Innocent's life. And they are going for the buildings. They're going for the tier 3. They are going for the
Jungler. Wings have completely shut down MVP's aggression. The train stopped here. MVP are going to have to figure something else out. You knew the fight was going to be hard for them when PA spent his entire BKB trying to kill a Warlock who's already dropped Golem. Can't even get that kill. Wings just completely crushed MVP.
QO could not stay on target. He was looking for at first that Drow Ranger, but the Hurricane fight came out and it's so tough for him to find any real particular target to hang on to and try to kill. So the Phantom Assassin, which was so successful earlier on in this tournament, not really coming up big for MVP this game, but it looks like the Wings fans behind us. Very excited.
The cheering section might be growing, Mon. I'm seeing more and more folks start to stand up here. At first, it was just the hardcore fans behind the Chinese casters, but now it's migrating towards the middle. Wings is getting some fans here at Key Arena.
that, we will jump into game two, but not before we head over to, of course, our draft panel. Dakota, what did you think about that game number one?
Hey there, Mott, how you doing? I thought it was pretty damn swell. We were expecting an action-packed matchup, and I think we got what we wanted. For you guys, though, I mean, we anticipated that, you know, MVP might go back for someone like the PA, and we know Wings to just kind of almost all random, it feels like at times, their draft, but do you